सो हेलो एंड वेलकम बैक स्टूडेंट्स, आई होप यू ऑल आर डूइंग वेल। हमने लास्ट टाइम पढ़ा था इंडिकेटर्स, और इंडिकेटर्स में हमने क्या क्या देखा था। हमने देखा था दो तरह का इंडिकेटर्स। वन वॉज द फर्स्ट विच इज बाई चेंजिंग कलर शोज वेदर एन एसिड और बेस इज प्रेजेंट विच इज इन कॉन्टैक्ट विद द पर्टिकुलर इंडिकेटर, राइट। एंड देन सेकेंड वाला जो था विच इज ऑल्सो नोन एज ओल्फैक्टरी इंडिकेटर, एंड दैट रिप्रेजेंट्स कि किस तरह से स्मेल चेंज होने से, बाई चेंजिंग द स्मेल अ पर्टिकुलर सब्सटेंस कैन आइडेंटिफाई एसिड और बेस और इंडिकेट एसिड और बेस, राइट। जिसमें वी हैव सीन मेनी एग्जाम्पल्स, लाइक इन नॉर्मल कलर चेंजिंग वाला इंडिकेटर वी हैव सीन फिनोफ्थैलिन, लिटमस एंड आई थिंक ब्रोमोफिनॉल वी हैव डन। There are n number of other indicators also. Then there is universal indicator also, that thoda sa I'll discuss over here, universal indicator. And also the olfactory indicators mein we have seen onion, right. And now today we will be doing, I have given you one homework, that was ki to find what happens when vanilla essence comes in contact with acid or base. I hope you might have done it. If not, then I'll help you with that. And one is also clove is also there. If you have not done vanilla, then please make sure that you search for clove oil. Okay? So let's see what are the basic points which has to be remembered for further indicator wala part. Okay? So the first one which I have given you as an homework was vanilla essence. Vanilla essence. Okay? You might have observed that it is having a very sweet smell, right? Very sweet smell. That is why it is being added to your cakes and pastries and ice creams, etc., right? Vanilla essence is added to cakes, pastries and ice creams because it is having a very sweet smell. But when you add vanilla into a base, so vanilla essence, when it comes in contact with the base, what will happen? And vanilla essence, when it comes in contact with acid, what will happen? So there are two things. That is, vanilla essence coming in contact with base, it is going to lose its, it will lose its sweet smelling property, right? So it will lose its sweet smell. But once you add acid again, the sweet smell of vanilla will be back. So that means ki the sweet smell is restored, right? So this is restored, I must say here, because pehle to sweet smell nikal gaya when I added base, but jaise hi acid add kiya, we have seen ki vanilla essence ka jo sweet smell tha, it is restored. So this was what actually I was expecting from you as a homework, but okay, fine. If you have done, it's very good, or if you have not done, your doubt has been cleared. The next homework is, please make sure ki clove oil ke upar zara aap search karo ki clove oil acid aur base mein kaise react karta hai. Then the second one is your universal indicator. Okay, so I hope you might have gone through it once again, because I'm repeating this once again, because this is an important indicator. As I have already told you about it, that it is made by mixing n number of indicators. It shows the pH. Maine bataya tha aapko, pH is a negative log to the base 10 of H plus ion concentration. That means ki kitna hydrogen ion nikla hai, kitna hydrogen ion dissociate hua hai, that is known as your H plus ion concentration. Uska jo negative log hota hai, usse hum pH kehte hai. Aur in simple layman ke terms mein, you can say pH is the strength of an acid. Theek hai? So universal indicator basically gives you the strength of an acid. Strength of an acid. Theek hai? What does this mean? I have already explained you about this. Strength of an acid is nothing but the acidity kitna zyada hai. Like for example, there are certain acids which are very harsh, ठीक है, विच आर वेरी स्ट्रॉन्ग एसिड्स, फॉर एग्जाम्पल HCl, H2SO4, व्हेन इट इज ड्रॉप्ड ऑन योर हैंड्स और वेर एवर इन योर स्किन इट गेट टच्ड, योर स्किन विल बी हार्म्ड. ऑल्सो इट रिएक्ट्स विगरसली विथ योर वॉटर, इट रिएक्ट्स विगरसली विथ मेटल्स एंड अदर सब्सटेंसेज विच विल बी सी इन द नेक्स्ट लेटर पार्ट ऑफ द चैप्टर, राइट. सो द यूनिवर्सल इंडिकेटर इज द वन which shows the strength of an acid by changing the color into a particular gradient which we have seen as a pH scale. ठीक है, in that the if suppose universal indicator when it comes in contact with a particular acid it shows, if suppose it turns to red that means it is a strong acid. ठीक है, and if this universal indicator comes in contact with weak acid it will turn somewhere around the orange yellow, right. So that will be the indication given by the universal indicator. If suppose it is in contact with a base it is going to give you dark blue color, right. So the universal indicator basically is giving you the strength of an acid or base. ठीक है, सो जो भी एसिड और बेस का स्ट्रेंथ है, वेदर इट इज अ स्ट्रॉन्ग एसिड वेदर इट इज अ वीक एसिड, इट इज बीन प्रोवाइडेड बाय यूनिवर्सल इंडिकेटर. आई होप इट इज क्लियर टू यू. वन मोर कॉन्सेप्ट वी हैव सीन इन द वेरी फर्स्ट चैप्टर, फर्स्ट लेक्चर ऑफ दिस चैप्टर इज स्वांते अर्हेनियस. स्वांते अर्हेनियस has given definition to acids and bases. ठीक है, so when he defined acids and bases he said that the substance which releases H+ ions on dissolution with water is an acid and the substance which releases OH- ion on dissolution with bases on dissolution with water is a base, right. A substance which releases OH- ion is a base, right, and which releases H+ ion is an acid. This has been given by Svante Arrhenius, but he also has given one very important thing about the acid base reaction. And what was that? We know that acid base reaction is nothing but your neutralization reaction. ठीक है, so as per Svante Arrhenius this neutralization reaction is basically the reaction between the H+ ions released by acid and OH- ions released by base giving H2O. So I will give you a very simple example by writing this. See, HCl, it liberates H+ and Cl-. Whereas, suppose NaOH, it liberates your Na+ and OH-. Clear? So, have you seen this? There is a release of H+ and OH- from acid and base, and when they combine they form water, and when this Na+ and Cl- combine they form salt, right, which is an NaCl is a sodium chloride which is a salt which is also known as common salt or table salt. I hope it is clear to you guys. So Svante Arrhenius has also defined neutralization reaction as the reaction between H+ and OH- ions. I hope this is very very clear to you guys. So we'll move to the today's further session. ठीक है, so I hope you might have noted down each and every point written on the board and it is very clearly visible, I hope. ठीक है, so let's move to the next point. So our next topic is the physical properties of acids. Okay, so this is how we are going to study basically. That is, first we'll go through the physical properties of acid, then chemical properties of acid. In the same way, we'll be doing physical properties of base and physical properties of chemical properties of bases. And then we'll be making a comparison chart of both, that is acids and bases. Clear? So let's start with the very first physical property of acid. So the very first physical property of acid is that we have already seen that, right? And that is, acids taste sour, or acids are sour to taste, which we have already seen ki there are many acids which we can consume also. They are known as organic acid, like your lemon acid. Your lemon is also containing an acid. Then all the citrus fruit basically contains citric acid. Then your dahi, the curd, it contains your lactic acid. Then your tomato, your tamarind, everything which is sour to taste is having some acid. But those acid are not harmful to us, basically because they are organic acid. What are organic acid? How do we classify them? We'll be seeing next to this, right? So acids taste sour, or acids are sour to taste, right? Now the second property is that acids such as the HCl, H2SO4, etc. are corrosive. Okay, so you can say acids are corrosive. Okay, all the acids basically are corrosive. Some show immediate reaction or very quick reaction, but some of the acids show very slow reaction. But all the acids are corrosive. We have seen this definition in the first chapter, right? In the chapter which we have done just before acids and bases, that is your chemical reaction. In that also, I have made you write the definition of corrosion as the reaction of metal with moisture or acid. Normally your notes do not give any such clarification. They always write reaction with moisture, because oxidation is taking place, right? And from moisture we are getting oxygen. तो यहाँ पे आपको ये चीज़ याद रखनी है कि जो corrosive nature है या corrosion होता है वो acids से भी होता है. And that is why we do not keep pickles in a metal container. Why we do not keep pickles? Because जो metals होते हैं they easily get react with the acid. ठीक है? So let's take an example. ठीक है? For example, this is a metal. Right, this metal, this is a metal. Kya example mein, this is a metal, right? And this is solid, right? This is solid in nature. But when a particular acid, for example HCl, it reacts with this metal, or when it comes in contact with the metal, it is going to react with the metal forming ZnCl2. Okay, if suppose it is present, the water is surrounding this, this will be formed in aqueous form. This is a salt and it is going to be formed in aqueous form, and this H2 will be released. Now when this is either in the powder or aqueous form, then definitely jo metal ka solid shape tha, it will be lost. And when the solid shape is lost, डेफिनेटली आपके जो कंटेनर है जिसमें अगर आपने सपोज पिकल रखा होगा, तो वो पिकल क्या करेगा, लीक कर जाएगा, बिकॉज वो कंटेनर में होल्स होने शुरू हो जाएंगे जहाँ भी ये एसिड और मेटल का रिएक्शन हो रहा है. सो इज दिस क्लियर? सो दैट मीन्स यहाँ पे कोरोजन हुआ मेटल का. क्लियर है? सो कोरोजन इज नॉट ओनली विथ योर मॉइस्चर बट ऑल्सो विद द एसिड्स. क्लियर? I hope this is very fine to you, very clear to you. And this reaction is not only with the mineral acid but also with the your organic acid, that is the weak acids. Clear? Now mostly jo aapke acids hote hain, most of the time these acids are either present in liquid or solid state, right? So acids are present in liquid or solid state. So you might be a bit confused कि solid state में आपने कहाँ देखा है. So yes, there are acids which are present in solid state. So basically, I don't know whether you people use or not, but there is a powder which comes with the name, that is InstaDrain. Okay, whenever there is a choke up in your pipeline, basin ke pipeline mein, washroom ke pipeline mein, whenever there is choke up pipeline which goes to the chamber, okay, so in that situation, to clean that pipe, what we add InstaDrain. These powders are basically containing either H2SO4, HNO3, these kind of acids, which when in contact with water easily releases the acidic property, or shows the acidic property, due to which the waste which have been stuck in the pipelines will be released. Okay, wo react kar jayega acid ke sath and it will be released, right? And the choke up will be cleared. So acids are present in liquid or सॉलिड स्टेट. लिक्विड में तो हमने बहुत देखा है, बट दे आर ऑल्सो फाउंड इन दे, वी कैन ऑल्सो स्टोर इट इन द फॉर्म ऑफ सॉलिड. आई होप दिस इज क्लियर टू यू. नाउ दिस वॉज द थर्ड फिजिकल प्रॉपर्टी, एंड द फोर्थ फिजिकल प्रॉपर्टी इज द वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट प्रॉपर्टी, दैट इज एसिड्स आर और एसिड्स कंडक्ट electricity in aqueous form. Aqueous form का मतलब क्या होता है? जब ये acid aqueous यानि water के साथ dissolve किया होगा, तब ये acid electricity conduct करता है. यानि कि when acid is dissolved in water or in aqueous form, that aqueous form of acid can conduct electricity. It is because the acid easily gets ionized in water. Suppose HCl is an acid, and this acid, when dissolved in water, it will release H plus and Cl minus ion. So since this HCl is present in ionized form in the aqueous solution, hence it can conduct electricity. I hope this is very very clear to you. So these are the four properties, right? And one more thing, this is the reason why we call acids as, hence acids are known as electrolytes. I hope this is very very clear to you. So this was all about the physical properties of the acid, right? So in the same way, we are going to study the chemical properties of acid, and then the classification of acids, right? So with this, I hope you are very thorough with what is acid, what is base, and what is salt. This has been done in the introduction lecture. Then in the next lecture, we have seen the indicators, the different types of indicators, right? There were two types of indicator which we have seen, that is one which changes the smell and one which changes the odor, right? That is the smell. Color and smell is being changed, and indicating that the substance which is in contact with that indicator is an acid, base or salt. Clear? And then we have seen about the acid ka physical properties. The very first one is sour to taste, already seen. Corrosive nature, that is whenever this acid comes in contact with any metal, that they are going to react with the metal, forming a salt, which is an aqueous solution maybe, or powder form. So due to which, depending upon the situation, right? And due to which, this metal will be slowly and steadily gets corroded, and hence you cannot store any acid in a metal container. Even if it is a organic acid, you cannot store it in a metal container. Clear? Then your acids are present in liquid or solid state. That is, whenever you say ki liquid state mein toh aapne dekha hai, but solid state mein I have given you one example ki they are stored. Okay? Basically, acids are stored in powder format, right? So they are present in solid state, which can be used further as and when required by just dissolving it with water. Clear? So solid and liquid are the two phases in which acids can be found. Then last one is, acids are also called as electrolyte because they can conduct electricity when dissolved in water. So I hope the whole part which I have discussed yet is very clear to you. So If you have any doubt, you can ask me anytime. So with this, I would like to wind up the session. We'll meet in the next session. Till then, bye-bye.